DNA polymerases catalyze the synthesis of the new DNA strands from a DNA template. DNA polymerases require a pre-existing RNA or DNA strand, the primer, to initiate new DNA synthesis. These polymerases add deoxyribonucleotides only to the 3' end of a growing strand. Taking a closer look at the nucleotide polymerization reaction, the 3' end of the primer contains a free 3' hydroxyl group. The 3' hydroxyl reacts with the 5' end of the next free nucleotide to be added. Free nucleotides continue to be added to the growing DNA strand by the same type of reaction. Overall, the new DNA strand grows in the 5' to 3' direction. A eukaryotic chromosome contains a long linear molecule of double-stranded DNA. This DNA is tightly coiled within the chromosome, but unravels during interphase, when DNA replication occurs. A eukaryotic chromosome contains multiple origins of replication. At each origin of replication, DNA synthesis proceeds bidirectionally. Two replication forks move outward in opposite directions. The replicating DNA helices from each origin elongate and eventually join each other. The original chromosome has been replicated to form two identical daughter DNA molecules, also called sister chromatids. DNA is replicated by continuous synthesis of a leading strand and discontinuous synthesis of a lagging strand of the DNA molecule. Coordination between leading and lagging strand synthesis is achieved by the dimerization of DNA polymerase molecules at the replication fork. The DNA polymerase moves with the replication fork. The polymerase at the leading strand template remains attached to the DNA, continuously synthesizing the leading strand. The lagging strand polymerase initiates DNA synthesis at the fork from an RNA primer made by a primase complex. The polymerase elongates the lagging strand in a direction opposite the fork, but stays bound at the fork. As a result, the newly synthesized lagging strand fragment loops out between the polymerase and the fork. Once the polymerase completes an Okazaki fragment, it dissociates from the DNA template. A new primer is produced at the fork. The polymerase reassociates with the template at this position to continue synthesis of the lagging strand. By this mechanism, the two polymerases can add nucleotides to the growing strand at the same time, and at rates up to 1,000 base pairs per second.